Hi everyone, it's Bonita from Pennies to Dollars, and today I thought I would clue you in on some of the extreme ways that we save money and I save money in our home and in our day-to-day lives. My parents were born in the Great Depression, so I was born where I grew up in a home where the bedroom didn't have any heat, and we only heated the rooms that we were in. And I actually live only about 1,000 feet from where I grew up. And we still live like that. We live where we only heat the rooms that we're in. And my house doesn't get super warm anyway. Sometimes we're really lucky for even it to hit maybe 62, 63 in the wintertime with us only heating the rooms that we're in. So I can only imagine how cold it would be if I opened up those other spaces. So we're going to talk today about some of the extreme ways that I save money. And as you can see, I am layered. I have on 2 shirts. I have on what they call cuddles that are kind of like Under Armour, but they're cheaper. My mother-in-law got me these and they're super warm, even though they're thin. So that's one of my layers. And then I have a scarf, which I wear very often in the winter to keep my neck warm. I found that if I can keep my neck warm and my core warm, then the rest of me stays warm. So I have a core sweater and I have layers. So I have 3 layers and a scarf. And then another thing that I wear in the winter that keeps me super warm are knee socks. And I found these super warm knee socks. And I got these, and when it is freezing cold outside, I wear these, and they are so comfortable. They kind of have this stretch that supports your foot, and they also have this stretch that supports your leg. And they are just a super warm sock. So if you wear them and it is not really cold outside, it will cook your goose, I promise you. So they are wonderful. If you're interested, I'll leave a link in the description box. And then I also have these old-fashioned leg warmers. And we wore these in the 80s when I was in high school. But they're back in style, I guess, at least to wear maybe even under your boots or under your pants or on top of your pants if you're at home. But they keep your legs super, super warm. So if you don't have any floor covering, like if you have hardwood floors or you don't have a rug that's thicker under your feet, these help a lot. And so sometimes I'll wear these knee socks and I'll wear these leg warmers over the top, and I have several different colors. So those are some of the tricks that I use to stay warm in my cold old farmhouse. And then some of the extreme things that we do is we keep everything shut off unless we are using it, except for the freezer and the refrigerator. We keep a thermometer in the refrigerator so that I can see if it's running in range. And if it's running too cold, we will turn it down a notch or two. A lot of times your refrigerators will go clear to 6, and sometimes mine are only on 4 because I don't need it to be on 6. So that's a way that we have found to be able to save money. We only use our hot water heater maybe about an hour every 3 days. And so I have a breaker that I will shut off, and we don't have it on all of that time except for about 1 hour every 3 days. And that is enough for the two of us to wash dishes, take showers, and have hot water. I realized that it pulled a lot of electricity and that we weren't using it all of those hours and we didn't need to keep it on constantly. I also keep my washing machine unplugged. I keep everything on power strips, including our Roku box, our television, our microwave, our toaster oven. Everything's on power strips. So we turn it on when we use it and we shut it off when we're not using it. We don't leave any of those things turned on or plugged in. We don't leave any chargers plugged in. We don't leave anything like that in our house plugged in, and it makes a substantial difference. I keep the breaker to my dryer shut off. I so rarely use my dryer. If it's snowing or if it's raining or if I don't feel good would be the only reasons that I would use my dryer. And if I didn't feel good, I would probably wait until I did feel good just to wash my clothes. So we don't keep that turned on either. That's a 220 breaker that pulls juice even if you're not using it. And so we keep our window units that are 220s. We keep all of that unplugged when it's not in season. We do not run a porch light at night. I see so many homes, if I'm out and about with their porch light on all night long, they feel like it's a safety reason. We shut our porch light off. We don't run it at night. We don't have any motion lights. In our living room, we have a lamp with one bulb that we will use. That's a three-way bulb, and we'll keep it on low if we feel like we need some light in the evening. Before, we were running an overhead light that had three bulbs, which now that I look back at it, it was so wasteful and so silly. We didn't need three bulbs to watch television. And so we switched to the one bulb, and that has made a huge difference. Just little things like that, if you go around and assess your home, can save you money. We have switched in our ceiling fan bulbs to these 40-watt chandelier bulbs. They fit perfectly, they use a lot less wattage, and you can see just fine. And so you don't have to spend so much on those ceiling fan bulbs if you switch to these, and you can get them at Dollar Tree. We've also switched to the nightlight bulbs in our chandelier. They also fit perfectly, and they're only 4 watts. So instead of using a 40-watt chandelier bulb, you can fit a nightlight bulb for 4 watts in its place. And then, of course, all of our bulbs were switched to LED. And I had put off doing that for a number of years. I don't know why. I guess I thought it was going to be expensive to switch them all out. But they also sell those at Dollar Tree for $1.25 a bulb. And they don't burn out as fast. And they save you money because they use less wattage. So buy your bulbs at Dollar Tree and you will save a bunch of money there. We also use the receipt and rebate links that I will post in the description that I've talked about before. Every single receipt that we get, I upload to multiple sites and just take the picture, and it saves me money, and I get cash back, and I get gift cards back that I use for my grandchildren for Christmas gifts. And it saves us a bunch of money. And I track all of that, so I know what I'm saving. And a lot of times I can make $50 or more per month by just taking pictures of my receipts. And that makes a difference over the year. And then of course I keep my list that we've talked about before. I keep a running list of anything I need, and I only buy it when I can afford to buy it or when it's on sale, and I work it into my budget. I just don't buy it because I need it, even if it's a food item. I just make something else. And then the electrical component again. There are so many ways that we can save money that we don't think about on a day-to-day basis. A microwave, an electric skillet, a toaster oven, those actually are more economical to run than an electric stove. They heat up fast, they cook fast, and then they're off. They're actually the most economical to run. So if you have those, maybe think about using them next time instead of using your electric stove. We have a gas stove, but still we will use those items because they are quicker and they don't use hardly any power. And then I only order online at Christmas. Everything else I buy in person, and I've touched on this in other videos, it helps me be able to happen up on sales and get better deals. And so I buy everything in person except at Christmas. And then at Christmas, I mainly do it because I do have grandchildren and children out of state. And that helps me to just directly have it sent to their house and not have to pay postage. So I looked up on my electric company's website to see what appliances used the most power. And I found it interesting that your refrigerator was one of the top 4. Also, your electric oven and stove was one of the top four. Dryer, of course, was in the top four. And then if you have a 40 plus inch TV, that was in the top four. How many people think about how large their television screen is? They put off a lot of heat. If you've ever stood next to them, you can feel the heat that they radiate. So in the summer, you're running extra air conditioning to pay for running your large screen TV. We have a 32 inch TV, and yes, I would love to have a larger one. But for every 10 inches that your screen is larger, you use up to 70% more energy. That is huge. So think about that the next time that you are looking at increasing your TV size. They even stated that if you binge watch TV on the weekends, that using that large screen TV will definitely increase your electric bill. So those are some of the extreme ways that we operate our home to save money. I hope that that was helpful. And I hope to see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.